Live from London, straight from the palace. Man, them a gallus, I text us like Dallas. Keep it a bean, yo, he talk nice cause the pussy gave me, how? Like that, keep it a stack. Bitches move wild cause they know I got bands. If he chatting, I don't give a damn. And I'm still getting money, I know who I am. Tryna be low, he gon' hit up my gram. If he smart, he gon' act like a fan. Thinking you bigger, they got your head gas. Bitches slow, so I get him a pass.
When I first met my now husband, my friends were really happy because I was so happy. But my British friend said to me, I'm sure he's great, but you shouldn't do it because the British tabloids will destroy your life.
I read somewhere that there were members of the royal household that were confused and upset that she woke up so early at 5 a.m. She's a normal Californian girl, gets up early and does yoga and meditates, and also sent a lot of text messages. I mean, what did they expect, that she was going to send messages via pigeon? So I think she's amazing. And the royal wedding had the whole world watching, and I think that her choice was brilliant. It was sophisticated, it was chic, it was grown up. It was an English designer, albeit one that was working for a French house, which in a way was a message to the world. Yes, I'm from somewhere else, but I belong. I thought she looked fantastic. The fact that she chose to walk down the aisle by herself, I also thought spoke for an independent woman. I think the picture of the Duchess of Sussex mother at the chapel at the wedding was so inspiring to so many women, men all over the world.
Meghan, are you proud of your husband?
I'm always proud of him.
If you love me, you don't have to hate her. And if you love her, you don't need to hate me.
You have no idea what you passed on.
I figured out what we can bring.
What?
You.
In the chair.
Comment alone, but the topic that I'm about to speak about is something that I've wanted to speak about for a while, so I'm going to use your comment to really drive it home and get across what it is that I want to say. So you said that you were surprised that Meghan would wear a fortune in jewelry to an orphanage to read to poor kids, and yet nothing at all here. And you're speaking about Harry and Meghan being at the UN this morning. As you can see here, she was wearing jewelry. This seems to be like her standard arm stack for like the past year now. So it looks like she was wearing Princess Diana's Cartier watch and her love bracelet, as well as her, of course, her engagement ring and her wedding bands as well. What you're referring to is the jewelry that she wore here when she was reading her book, The Bench, to children back in September of 2021. Also, you were incorrect because it wasn't an orphanage, it was an elementary school. And I have a question to ask you. You said that she was reading to poor kids. What about these kids is giving poor? Like, I really wanna know. I think I already know your answer, but I would like to see if you actually have the balls to say it. But back to the topic at hand, in this photo here, the jewelry that she was wearing is pretty much the same jewelry that she was wearing today, except the fact that she's also wearing a tennis bracelet in this photo, and the tennis bracelet also belonged to Princess Diana. As long as she's wearing Princess Diana's watch and her and the engagement ring and her wedding band, she's always gonna be wearing a fortune, but it's so weird that you would just use that to actually take an actual dig at her since she didn't purchase those jewelry items. The love bracelet is hers because she's had that for years, even before she even met Harry, but it's so weird that you would actually zoom in to that. This is a part of a larger issue. This isn't just about Meghan. This has to do with a larger issue. Of course, I know that Meghan isn't black, that she is biracial, but just stay with me for a moment. There's a larger issue that, you know, whenever someone sees, you know, a black woman, biracial, woman of color, whatever, whenever you see them with, you know, with something expensive, why is it that you need to go and question them and make it seem like they shouldn't be able to have these items? This even happens on this app. If you look under the Black Girl Luxury hashtag, you'll see comments about people, you know, grilling these girls, asking them, you know, how and the why and the when and all these questions about why they have, you know, these luxury items and the fact that they don't deserve to have it.
Thing is, though, is that Meghan could have never worn a dramatic or statement-making dress. Because could you imagine what the press would have done to her? I could literally see the headlines. Who does she think she is? She thinks she's queen. She's trying to be better than Kate Middleton. Meghan Markle's wedding dress had so much pressure around it because she had so much pressure around her. But still, even though it was more simple, I think the accessories made it shine. Her veil was so stunning. I love a dramatic veil. It was almost 16 and a half feet long. And then, of course, her amazing tiara. One of my favorites that I've seen the royals wear. Here's more about the tiara from People magazine. It was borrowed from the Queen herself and came from Queen Mary, wife of King George V. I also loved her jewelry. She wore Cartier earrings and a beautiful Cartier matching bracelet. You can kind of see it in this photo. One thing I would love to see, though, of a close-up of are her shoes. I feel like we never got a good look at those. I know they're Givenchy, just like her dress was.
She looks just like a dream, the prettiest girl I've ever seen.
I've been drinking more alcohol for the past 5 days. Did you check on?
Thank you. probably noticed that a certain show, Suits, has become a phenomenon yet again on Netflix.
Wild?
45 billion minutes have been watched.
Is that right?
45 billion, okay, as of this week. We just found out 24 minutes ago that is the number.
But who's counting?
But literally, who's counting? What do you think is behind this renewed love for the show? Why has it become such a phenomenon again?
I have no idea. It was great to work on. Such a great cast and crew. We had a really fun time. I was on it for 7 seasons, so quite a bit. But it's hard to find a show you can binge watch that many episodes of these days, so that could have something to do with it. But good shows are everlasting.
Anna, but you hate me.
Toddler.
I think in the moment I see a lot of my wife and Archie.
Little Archie.
It is Prince Archie's birthday, and in honor of his birthday, I wore my Prince shirt. Mr. Archie Mabotton. Did I say it right? It is his 5th birthday, guys. This kid is... This is probably one of the most powerful people in the world, and here is why. Because he's just a child now, but once he becomes an adult, do you realize Archie has the ability to become king and the president? That is power. And that is why people are so mad. People are so mad about this, but that is why Prince Archie is probably is the MVP of them all. Of them all. And shout out to Harry and Meghan, because what they have done protecting their kids, keeping them from the prying eyes, the criticism. They've done so much to protect their kids, and I respect that. And I really hope one day that they get more credit for that, because that isn't an easy task to do when you're such big public people, and they have done it successfully. So again, shout out to Prince Archie. It's your birthday. Happy birthday. And I wish you many more. And yeah. Prince Archie birthday, guys. Shout him out. And guys, if you enjoy my content, please make sure you give your boy a follow, like, share, repost this video, and leave a comment. I would love to know what you think.
Was that a good song?
That was such a good song. It was awesome.
You want me to play it again, Mama?
Yes, please. Thank you. Okay.
I'll always love you. I let go a breath of you, just a sweet word, sweet word.
The Duke and Duchess of Sussex, Prince Archie and Princess Lilibet were spotted at the 4th of July parade in Montecito, California.
Watch this.
So much of what Meghan is and how she is so similar to my mom. She has the same compassion, she has the same empathy, she has the same confidence.
Archie.
She has this warmth about her.
Did you do a hand? Oh, this is it. This is why I filmed this.
I accept that there will be people around the world who fundamentally disagree with what I've done and how I've done it.
Haters.
But I knew that I had to do everything I could to protect my family.
Grandma. Yeah.
Grandma. Especially after what happened to my mum.
Yeah. That's your grandma, Diana.
You know, I didn't want history to repeat itself.
Well, if that doesn't bring a damn tear to your eye, then I don't know what else could. I mean...
There were moments of gold and there were flashes of light. There were things we could never do again, but then they'd always seem right.
A lot of my mum and Millie. She's very Spencer-like. She's got the same blue eyes.
Blue, blue, blue eyes.
Cause sometimes I look in her eyes and that's where I find my lips of us.
Isn't she lovely? Isn't she wonderful? Isn't she precious? Less than 1 minute. Oh, I never thought through love would be making one as lovely as she. But
first of all, let's say congratulations. We're the new addition to your family. Meghan said she wanted to wait until you were here to tell us, is it a boy or is it a girl?
You can tell her.
No, good girl.
No, no.
It's a girl.
Oh, Dad. You're going to have a daughter.
Wow.
It's a girl.
There was something that felt so complete once we had Lilibet.
Happy birthday to the prince who should be king. Happy birthday to the prince amongst men. Happy birthday to the man who is changing lives one Invictus Games at a time. Happy 39th birthday, Prince Harry. I declare a continued year of peace and prosperity for you and your family in your 39th year. Happy birthday.
Phew.
Thank you, Elizabeth, Israel, and Kirsty. Stay here. You need to be with me. I'd like to begin by expressing my deepest gratitude to everyone at the Pat Tillman Foundation, led by Marie Tillman Shenton, who I'm so honored is here tonight. I'd also like to acknowledge the Tillman family, especially Mrs. Mary Tillman, Pat's mother. Her advocacy for Pat's legacy is deeply personal and one that I respect. The bond between a mother and son is eternal and transcends even the greatest losses. The truth is, I stand here not as Prince Harry Pat Tillman Award recipient, but rather a voice on behalf of the Invictus Games Foundation and the thousands of veterans and service personnel from over 20 nations who have made the Invictus Games a reality. This award belongs to them, not to me. That said, it is of great importance to me to highlight these allies, athletes, and their amazing families for their achievements, their spirit, and their courage at every opportunity, especially on nights like this in front of people like you. Moments like these help us reach those that need Invictus most and reduce more than 20 veterans a day taking their own lives in this country alone. For those who may not know, Invictus comes from Latin, meaning undefeated or unconquerable. Nelson Mandela credited the poem of the same name, written by the poet William Ernest Henley, for giving him the strength to endure nearly 30 years of imprisonment. Like that poem, the spirit of the Invictus Games transcends race, time, and borders. It is born from unity and exudes purpose. This year, we're celebrating 10 years of witnessing life-changing impact and healing through sport. And while so much progress has been made since those first games, the world outside seems to be in an even more precarious state. We live in an age marked by polarization and division. Conflicts rage around the globe. Anger and resentment towards those who are different seem to pervade societies everywhere. Our community challenges that. Our community proves that unity is not just possible, but formidable. The beauty of the Invictus Games lies in how it brings people together, no matter one's nationality, background, or personal struggles. It is a collective built from courage and mutual respect, where athletes discover time and time again the common denominator of their humanity. Having survived the crucible of armed combat and forged through the challenge to rebuild bodies and minds impacted by conflict, they form a family. They exemplify the very best in all of us. There is a military expression that dates back to Roman times. I'll spare you another Latin lesson. But the phrase translates roughly to leave no one behind. And they hold particular significance for the US Army's Rangers. And I have no doubt Pat Tillman and his comrades lived by those words. So, it is fitting that I end with them and make a promise on behalf of all of us at the Invictus Games Foundation. No matter the road ahead, we are here for you. We will leave no one behind. Thank you.
It's not Eugenie, it's Eugenie. Because those Windsor jeans. Lots of discussion since yesterday when we got our first good look at Meghan and Harry's daughter Lilibet about who she looks like. I will show you the top contenders and be sure to let me know where you think there is the most resemblance. Right off the bat, between her parents, Meghan and Harry, I definitely think Harry's jeans won for the most part. Also, go follow Duchess MM Grace on Instagram, top tier content. Here's a closer look with Lily and Harry side by side. The red hair alone, I mean, come on. But also like her eyes and her nose, it's just so cute. next side by side with Meghan, a lot of people pointed out the similarities in the shape of their lips, which is, again, adorable. I hope she has her mother's mouth. The one I immediately saw was a young Princess Eugenie. I mean, come on. Eugenie and Harry have always been really similar, so it kind of makes sense that this is also a thing. Also, with baby August, Eugenie's son, who we got a look at this weekend, they're cousins distantly, but they could be siblings. Speaking of siblings, I had to throw Archie in here. Little sister. And finally, the one that most people are excited about is the similarity between Lilibet and the Queen. It's the chubby cheeks, isn't it? At the end of the day, I am absolutely losing my mind that Meghan was pregnant for a whole 9 months with this child and just gave birth to a Saxe Coburg Windsor clone. Again,
it was through scholarships, financial aid programs, and work study, where my earnings from a job on campus went directly towards my tuition, that I was able to attend university. And without question, it was worth every effort. Everyone should be afforded the opportunity to receive education that they want, but more importantly, the education that they have the right to receive. And for women and girls in developing countries, this is vital. Providing them with access to education.
I'll sit and watch your car burn with the fire that you started in me, but you never came back to us.
Listen to my heart.
So dumb. Y'all did all that and she's still a senior level princess. Like, how do you feel? How do you truly feel? Yes, she is now a Nigerian princess. And for those who do not know, she is 43% Nigerian, for the comments in the back. Baby, these three men went and got their princess and brought her home, okay? Imagine being kicked out of the royal family, treated horribly, just to be picked up and loved by her own people. Beautiful story, okay? Now, she was christened in Lagos, right? She was draped in royal beads in honor, and they gave her a name, but I do not want to butcher it, so. But the name means the crown or royal from across the seas. I love this for her. She was treated so badly in the British royal family, so for her to just come home, you know, be treated this way, love this for her. And make sure y'all follow that YouTube. I'll be on live. I'll see y'all. Bye, y'all.
It's also been a great way for me to connect with people, like Emily, who's right here. I only know her through Twitter, and I knew she was coming because I saw it on social media.
Stop it, really?
Yes. And she's going on a trip soon to Costa Rica to do some aid work because she said that my UN stuff inspired her.
No way. I was walking into work today and caught this moment outside.
Goliath with the sling. This very moment I bring, put it on everything. That I will retire with the ring, and I will retire with the crown.
I will always love you. How I do. I let go of a pain for you. It's a sweet word.
Like about corn?
A note from Professor Espy. I once saw Meghan and Harry at a famous sushi restaurant in Santa Monica on the 4th of July. I was picking up my sushi to go and on a date with my girlfriend. Meghan is in fact a Disney princess. It's unreal how beautiful she is in real life. Also, my mom saw Prince Harry at the mall once. He's very tall. There were no crowds. He was just shopping. Hope you enjoyed the video and don't forget to subscribe.